What's going on, guys? I believe today marks day 39 days till Raw, I believe. I didn't get much work done yesterday. It's been flooding and raining. You know, the hurricane coming up, you know, up here is just, it's crazy. So, yeah, it's been flooding. It's crazy out there today. It took me like triple the time to get home from work, and my shop is a mile away. So just let that sink in your head. But today we are going to get all the motor mounts complete. And I'm still waiting on the head tube, unfortunately. So we can't do anything with the front end. But that's okay. So I guess we'll do the motor mounts. And then maybe we could start the tank if we have time. I'd like to start the exhaust pretty soon. I'm just waiting on all the axle pieces and the mounts so then we can mount the back tire. But with the back, what I'm gonna do is originally, most of the frames that I make, they have this triangle piece, and then I would cut out in the center, you know, so I could put this in there and bolt it in there, and then I make them cover over it so it covers it all. But with this one, being that the tire is huge, I wanted to lower this a little bit to get my ground clearance up more. So what I'm actually gonna do here is get the live axle mounts. You know, there's the square with the little notch at the bottom with the square holes drilled out in them. So I'm gonna mount those here on each side. That way it gives the tire just a little bit more, you know, ground clearance. So with this, what we're gonna do is I'm having my buddy machine up this exact triangle, then cut out the word cat in it, and then behind where he cuts out, I'll weld some mesh in it. It'll be powder coated. Then when we assemble it, we'll actually put yellow LED lights in here, and the cat will actually glow when I turn it on. What I also got, let me go get it over here. I got two start buttons. Well, actually, I've had them. I don't know what I was going to use them for at the time. And I got the starter switch. So, and what I was thinking about doing was mounting them, making a plate, you know, right here. And then what I was gonna do was either, I got green or red, you know, they're just two pull switches and the key switch. So they'll go here, you know, the start, the key will go here, and then the push will go somewhere right here. But I was gonna try to utilize maybe these bolts and make, you know, a plate that goes right here so I can keep those controls down here. I mean, I was gonna put it up here, you know, somewhere by the head tube, but then I gotta run all that wiring down here. The wiring's already down here, you know, literally right here. So I'd like to do that, you know, just to keep everything, keep all the wiring minimized. I don't wanna be running stuff everywhere, making it complicated. But yeah, so I guess we'll just get right into it again. As if it wasn't wild enough what we're already doing here, why not make it suicide shift? Made it out of rebar so it matches. I put this nice bend in it. I don't know, I might chrome it, you know, or polish it like the rest of the stuff on the motor, but I like it. I think it looks pretty cool, you know? You know, don't go too far. So. Oh. There you go. So yeah, I guess, you know, I'll do that. I could always change it later though, if I don't like it. You know, it's just that one little thing. All right, guys, so I got the front motor mount started. I hope it works okay. You know, I've never really messed with one of these motors before. So, you know, this is my first time doing this as well, but that's okay. I'm gonna gusset it up a lot more, obviously, so it doesn't bend. But here, I'll show you. You tell me what you think. So this is the front of the motor, and this is where it'll be kind of adjustable. So you got the main bolt going through here that goes through both. And then I welded some bungs on there that are the same size hole
as the motor mount. Then I got some grade 8 threaded rod that runs through the front. And what I'll have is a nut here and a nut here. And I'll take one of those spacers and slice it like a pizza. So therefore, I could slide one end on here, one end on here. That way the nuts are touching all the way around and not just, you know, the end down here and the end up here. So that way everything's snug on both sides. But it should be able to pull the motor up or push the motor back depending on what bolt I tighten or loosen. So I think that's pretty good for that one. And then, you know, I'll do the one up here. And then I might do one more if I could find one. Maybe underneath or something, or up top.
But that should work. You know, like I said, we're not going to be racing this thing and doing like top speed all the time. So I'll leave it at that. So I'll go get all that stuff done and I'll update you in a few. Okay, so two things we got to go do right now. One, we got to go get these type of nuts at my dad's shop because I don't have any here. And number two, we're going to cut these motor mounts out of 12-gauge stainless on the big shear. So, you know, I don't have to plasma cut them and grind them, and it'll take me a while. But what I'm also going to do is we're going to make, instead of foot pegs for right here, I'm going to make a 5-inch floorboard that comes about 14 inches back. Then it's going to taper down to about right here. So it'll look, you know, something like that. And it'll be all polished diamond plate on both sides to match the triple trees and the back covers. So, you know, just give it a little bit more of the theme. And it's already chrome. I have some small strips already. I got like 6 or 7 inch strips. So that should work pretty good. So I'll see you guys there.
If I hit it one time, I'm a piper. If I hit it two times, then I like her. If I three times, I'm a wifer. It ain't safe for the black.
All right, guys, I got those pieces bent up. So, or not bent up, made up, I should say. So let's head back now and install. All right, guys, I got the motor mounts in. The only thing I did forget, of course, was the nuts for the front ones. So I guess I'll just get those tomorrow. It doesn't really matter right now. So here's what I came up with the back. You know, there's the plate that I cut and I drilled a hole, notched it out, you know, under here, and then put a gusset up here. If you can see that, hold on. So on both sides, I mean, the motor's solid. I shake the whole motor, the entire freaking table moves. So I put this cover back on. That's really it.
I did get this wire mesh as well. It's like stainless and it's perforated mesh.
I wanted to try to use it somewhere. I was gonna put it, you know, on here like I said, but you know, holding it up from the side, you know, maybe I could do something like that. I don't know, it kind of looks cool. Could close it all in a little bit. So, I don't know. But it's going good right now. So, I'll definitely make that plate tomorrow too for all the switches that goes right here. I'll make that tomorrow as well. But I don't know, I'm running out of stuff to do because I don't have the front end yet. Once I have the front end and the back axle, I'll keep going and going and going until it's done. So waiting on parts, it's always fun. I'll figure out what next to do.
What's up, guys? Another day. I've just been going at it. I was ordering parts earlier and then I just started work and I just didn't even start filming. So no big deal, I didn't do anything major. Just what I said I was gonna do yesterday and I didn't do. So I got the nuts on the front. It works. You could actually crank the hell out of it, and there's only two tacks on it right now, so just wait till I weld it. I got the floor pans mocked on there. I still gotta run the tubing on both sides. I reinforced the bottom motor mount. But yeah,
that's what I got so far. So I was figuring out, oh, and I did do this. I put the exhaust manifolds on and got them ready for the new exhaust. So what the new exhaust is gonna do, it's gonna elbow down, follow the same line as the frame, go underneath, split out right here after, come out a little bit, and then I don't know if I'm gonna put a 45 and then the little flapper or just leave it straight up. I think I'm gonna leave it straight up. That's how most of them are on the Catarpillars. Besides, like on the newer ones, it just 45s and then it's a shortcut and then it just dips out. There actually are no flappers. It's an older thing. So I don't know. I like it. I wanna hear the little flappers working and stuff. So yeah, though, that's what I got so far. So I'll keep going. All right, guys, so I got this frame for the footboards or foot deck, whatever you want to call it. I got the frame all tacked up on it. So I'll do the same thing for the other side, and then that'll bolt on there. I'll tap and drill the holes out. But I like the look of it because it goes with, you know, all the angled cuts on the frame. So it looks really good. I really like this bike because there's not a lot of round, you know, rounded edges and stuff like that. It's all raw, sharp edges, which is really cool. It's different. It goes with the theme. So yeah, I guess I'll bang out that other side now. Both sides for the floorboards. So as you can see, that'll just sit right on there, just like that. Might have to do a little bit of trimming to make everything fit just perfect, but that's that for both sides. Pieces right there. So now what I'm gonna do is make the little key switch area and start button. But I did pick this up over the weekend too. It's a little filter though. This was on here before and it went to the old filter box or intake box. So this was $10 at AutoZone. And I just figured, you know, it looks much better than a giant tube. So, and it's solid, you know? So yeah, I'll get on that. All right, guys, so I got the panel all on there. I'm probably gonna make another bracket going back too. So over time it doesn't wobble. I mean, it's solid as it is. It's, you know, it's pretty, not thick diamond plate, but it's thicker than regular sheet metal. So you'll put the key in, turn the key, this will start, you know, you hold it, it'll start. And those are also two pull switches. So, and for whoever doesn't know what that means, I can have this button operate two things opposed to just one. So what I'm going to do is it's obviously going to start the starter motor. But I'm also going to put a few strobe lights in the motor. So when you turn the motor over, it'll also flash on the motor. Then once it starts, it'll go off. So it'll be like almost a two-in-one deal. But it's pretty solid. And then, you know, to shut it off, you just shut it off, take the key out, and then you won't be able to start it. So I think it looks pretty good. And I do have different color. Like I could put a red one here if I wanted to match that or whatever else, but green means go, so I figured, you know, that would be the best thing. So, yeah. Okay, so I decided to do something totally crazy and insane, but why not? You thought the suicide shift was gonna be crazy enough? No, that doesn't satisfy me. Biggest question I have is, what does a dump truck do? Well, I think a dump truck dumps. So, I don't want to give away any hints, but I think I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna try to make the tank actually dump. So what I have planned for this is a lot more simple than you think. little latch.
This will get welded to the tank after the channel is all patched back up. So it'll be welded there, and there'll be a bolt going through here, bolted to the frame. And then over here in the front, I have just enough room in between the motor mounts and the exhaust for a 4 to 5 inch actuator.
What an actuator is, it's a... Actually, I might have one here. No, I don't have one here right now. But all it is, it's an aluminum cylinder with a little motor at the bottom that when you activate power going one way, it pushes it up. You activate it the other way, it pushes it back down. So I'll mount it in here off of the frame. I'll have two mounts coming off the bottom of the tank on each side that are connected with a bolt. So when you activate it, it'll push the entire tank up. And then when you push it down, it'll come back down. And while you're riding, there'll be a safety on the frame that locks the two pins together with a little pin and hook or something like along those lines. But I feel like that'd be a really cool feature as far as, you know, making it functional as a tank and a dump truck. You know, I won't be dumping anything out, obviously, unless you run out of fuel and you want to get all the fuel to the back of the tank, then, you know. But for shows and stuff, I feel like that would be perfect. Excuse me. So I'm gonna head to the shop right now, make a channel, we'll weld it in, and I might have an actuator up there, so I'll bring that back. I'll see if that would fit, but I think it's like an 8-inch one. It's much too big for what I'm trying to use it for, but if I can get it to work, I'll make it work. So I'll see you over there. All right, guys, so I did have an actuator. It's way too big, as you can see. This is a 12-inch stroke, so it will not fit anywhere in here. So I did just order one half the size of this, a 6-inch stroke, so it will be more than enough to lift it. So I got it all in there. I just got to weld it all up. But that'll sit up there like this. So we're getting there. That's about all I can do with the tank until I have that actuator here. So I guess that might be it for today. You know, we got a lot done today. We got that. We got the key. And started mocking up the tank on there. So I guess we'll see you tomorrow. Always lit. Yeah, I'm never sober. It's been 3 days in a row. Y'all coming over. Told that. What do you guys think of the new do? I think I look like Machine Gun Kelly. Do I look like Machine Gun Kelly? He's dead though, so. Dropping, got the city on fire. Lying on me like she tired. I'ma have to run and call Kamaya. Ho, turn up the pot, I'm a liar. And girl, I hit it one time, I'm a piper. If I hit it two times, then I like her. Yeah. Three times, I'm a wiper. It ain't safe for the black or the white girls. It ain't safe, it ain't safe, it ain't safe, it ain't safe. Tell your man, pipe up, pipe up. And it bands from the safe in your face where you say, my hands turn it into a nightclub. Hey, hey. And then I get some money. And then I get some money. And then I get some money. Yeah. All right, guys, the tank is all welded up. And I got both sides, you know, all welded. And right now I have the latch tacked on there and threaded into the frame with a bolt. So now all I'm waiting on is the actuator to actually mount in here and make the brackets. But right now it does function. And it does actually flap all the way over. It's not going to go that far. It's probably only going to go about, you know, that far at most. So, but it still looks good. You can't tell it does it, you know, just by looking at it from a glance. And, you know, that's what I want it to do. So, I might just make one small little piece in here and put little lights in here on each side that actually work. But other than that, that's that. I'll take it off now because I didn't weld
the latch fully. It's just tacked, so
I'll take that back off and weld that up, and we can start the next area.
Alright, I got that all welded up underneath. I got the filler on, or the, not the filler, the drain on for it, so that's just gonna go right there. And I put it kind of on an angle when it tips. You know, it still won't hit anything, you know. So it's a bit close to the rebar, but it should be okay, you know. But yeah, I think that's pretty good. So next I'll actually put the filler in the top. So I'll get that done. All right, filler's on. Works. Level. And it dumps. So I'm just waiting on the actuator, you know.
And we can go from there. I'll try to figure out what's next. Okay, so what I'm actually going to do now is I'm going to thread all the bolts that are going to hold the floorboards down. I just got some self-tap sheet metal screws in it right now, just holding it down, but I'll go ahead and drill a few more and then tap and drill all of them, you know, both sides. That way that's done. That's one less thing I got to do after breakdown. So I'm just trying to have everything done that has to be done on the frame. So when we break it down, all we have to do is fully weld it, then send it out to the powder coater. That way there's basically almost no prep before that. So we'll get on that. The goals, drive a rave, get some money, the rolly, patty face. My career taking off, he's jogging in pace. Where these hoes on their mouth, are these out of shape? Can you stop with all the subs? I ain't cherry. If you really want some smoke, you can pull up, you can get it. Grab a hand full of braids, make it. Put a white boy on the song, I might turn GEC out. Keep it G from the goal to the end, from the start. You know me, Cardi B, popping on the charts. If I hit it one time, I'm a piper. What's going on, guys? Today is Tuesday. I don't know how many days till Raw. I haven't been trying to keep account of that, but today we got everything from BMI that we need, including the back axle, the sprocket, chain, a seat, all the hubs, some brake parts, pretty much all the goodies that we're gonna need to get this back axle on today, including the actuator that we need to raise the tank came in as well. So, you know, nice little small 6-inch one, half the size, that way it'll fit in there perfect. So we're not gonna waste any time today. We're just gonna get right into it, and I'll just set the camera up and you guys can watch me fly. Alright guys, so I got the back axle all tacked on. As you can see, I put the wheel on. I had to finagle some stuff. I winded up taking the wheel back off and putting the sprocket on the wheel instead of the brake on the wheel, just because I would like the caliper closer to the frame as possible. So I got it on here though. I just gotta put the tensioner, you know? The chain was perfect length though, like right out of the box. I didn't add a link or take a link off, and that is all I ordered. So that was like perfect. I could not believe that. So this will go in here. You know, there'll be a bracket right off of here, so this can go up and down. But that's on there. Looks good from the back. The wheel's gotta go this way just a little bit, but as you can see, this is what I meant with the caliper. You know, I want it
close to the frame as possible. But you know, I could move it wherever I want it now. So.
So yeah, I guess I'll get the rest of that all squared away. I'm not gonna weld it obviously until the frame's completely done, but I can get that on. And then maybe we could put it either up on the table all the way or on the ground all the way and get a ride height and see what we can cut the front forks.
Yeah, it ain't nice, fam. You can study where I'm from on my vice land. This is nothing new to me, this my life, fam. I could pull a million girls from a mic stand. Pull one at my show cause I like fans. Later on I got two in my night plan.
It dumps. Can you believe that? That is so cool. It is just all mangled on there right now. You know, it's got a temporary bracket. You know, it's obviously all going to be much nicer and much more secure than that. But I was too excited. I wanted to see it work, you know. So that's a big step today for the bike and for me personally, too. To have something as a double feature like that, you know, double purpose is just awesome. Being that that's a working tank and it's a dump truck, it dumps. That's so cool to me. So I'll button the rest up and then I'll try it again and I'll show you, you know, I'll set the camera up where you can really see it good, you know, like here or something or here and you can watch it dump. So I'll get all that set. Okay guys, it's getting late. I got the entire hydraulic or actuator mounted for the tank. I just got a piece of styrofoam in there now to test the durability of it. It seems pretty good, so I'll just get like a foam gasket and put that underneath. But I made this nice little wraparound diamond plate piece to keep it in the area. I have some washers in there for now to space it, but I'll make spacers when it comes time for assembly. And I just mounted the rear brake caliper. It's just tacked on there now, you know. But it lines up perfect and I can move the rotor, you know, back and forth wherever I want if I have to adjust it. It does have to come in toward the wheel a little bit, but that should be pretty solid, you know. It's just the two mounting bolts, so you can take them off, swing it open and change the pads, but it'll look good. Then the fender will come and wrap around, you know, down to about here, say. So and then it'll go in right here. But I think I'm gonna put the battery here, or if I can't do it here, I'm gonna have to sink it in the fender up here underneath the seat. So I'll see where the best place to do it is. If I do it over here, I'd like to make it out of diamond plate to match the rest. But if not, I'll just make a regular metal one. And I'll have it powder coated the same color. So all we got left to do for the chain and the back axle is just mount this tensioner, you know, over here, and then that's the entire back, and then it could be all welded up, you know, besides the fender. So I think that's enough for today, and we'll see you in the next video. Like, comment, and subscribe for the chance to win the care package. That includes 4 tickets to Raw, 4 Cat t-shirts, and Impact t-shirts, and a bunch of other Impact goodies I'll throw in there as well. So let's get those subscribers up. Winner's not going to get picked until 500 subscribers this time. So share that video. Get all the likes up there. Thanks, guys. Talk to you later.